Hello everyone, a couple of weeks ago, my little brother James said that he wanted me to get him every episode of SpongeBob SquarePants. Unfortunately, I didn't have all of them. So I decided to go searching on eBay to see if I could find episode box sets. I had absolutely no luck finding any. I then saw a pop-up on the side of the site, saying in bold yellow letters over an ocean background, "Click here for all your SpongeBob needs." I figured that it might have what I need, so I clicked the weird ad. When I did, I swore I heard a faint sobbing noise right before I clicked it. I was quickly sent to a strange SpongeBob-themed website. I've since forgotten the name of the site. There were different links at the top of the page. Some were labeled banned episodes, knockoffs for sale, and illegal episodes. The one that caught my eye was one that was titled, "Free Box Set List Download Day." In it, there were images of SpongeBob's hand, holding up his left hand along with his fingers to associate what season each download link had in it. I was able to download season 1 through 6, since my little brother liked the older seasons of the newer ones. It took some to download the seasons I got, each taking around an hour to download. Once all the seasons had finished downloading, they showed up on my desktop with the icon displaying and same image of SpongeBob's hand with the numbers displaying which season it was. I checked to make sure the files didn't have any viruses or Trojans in them. There weren't, luckily. I watched some of the episodes on the file sets and to my surprise, they were all in great quality. But when I got to season 4, I saw a file titled, sadness.wmb in all lowercase letters. I was curious to see what that particular episode had. I burnt the file onto a blank DVD I had in my desk. After that, I went into James' room, which wasn't far from the living room and my own, and told him that I got all his favorite seasons onto one disc. His face beamed with joy and excitement. I then put the disc into his TV as he jumped up and down in pure joy. I then left his room as he began to thank me and give me a big hug. While my little brother was having fun watching his favorite TV show, decided to make some noodles for myself as a snack. As I was about to finish them, I heard my little brother scream and call my name in pure fear. I ran in the room, and he was curled up in the corner of his room, shaking and looking completely mortified with his back turned away from me. I looked at the TV, wondering what had scared him so much, and saw Patrick sitting next to SpongeBob's house. He was frowning, and his eyes were black sockets. What looked to be blood was dripping out of the gaping holes in his head, and he started to cut his own stomach open with a strange-looking coral, nothing but a weird red chunky pus poured out from the starfish's self-inflicted wound. Right before he could finish disemboweling himself, the screen went to a faint static. I shocked into a frozen state. I told James that what he saw was just a dream, and that he just tired himself out from getting exited earlier. It managed to calm him down slightly. I thought it was just some sort of demented trick or something of the like. Later, after James went off to bed, I got the DVD, put it into my computer and watched the episode. There wasn't the standard intro that played at the beginning of every episode, just a picture of a noose while the theme song was muffled and slightly distorted. The title card just said, "Sadness," with the background being a bloody red color. It showed SpongeBob's house at night. It cut to show the inside of his house. SpongeBob, his parents, his friend Patrick, and Gary were in there. There was no music throughout the scene. Just the sound of the wind howling. Then Gary started sobbing, and his eyes started to gain blood in it, dripping from out of his sockets. I started feeling sick, and I felt like I just threw up inside my mouth. The sound of wind went silent, and SpongeBob's parents started talking in robotic voices.
"We're going on the road trip."
Gary started crying even harder, but his voice sounded more deeper. He went completely silent. He was still crying but wasn't making any sound. Gary then suddenly died. He laid on the floor, missing his eyes and looking very sad. Patrick looked on and sounded bored, saying,
"No thanks, I'm not going to the road trip."
It showed them all in the car. SpongeBob was in the back, messing around and taking some sort of pill, and began laughing hysterically. His voice sounded more deeper than the original. It now shows a picture of Patrick's head slowly spinning and his eyes were black, the same ones I saw when I found my mortified brother. He didn't have a mouth, just pitch black where his eyes should be, and he said, in a scared tone,
"No! No! No! No!"
I was freaking out at the disturbing image. Then, SpongeBob jumped out the car window, then shortly after, getting hit by an oncoming car. Patrick, now with his mouth back, began to screech as yellow liquid started pouring from his open mouth. SpongeBob's parents stopped the car, the brakes sound like glass breaking, and begged to walk up to his body. They had black holes for eyes, and then a bright yellow liquid started dripping out of their eyes. It shows them at SpongeBob and Gary's funeral, and their bodies lay there, distorted. SpongeBob's teeth were a pink color, his nose wasn't drawn on, and he was covered in a blue liquid. Gary was eyeless and his shell was soaked in the yellow liquid. Patrick began to sob, and SpongeBob's parents followed as well. However, it didn't sound like cartoon crying, instead it sounded like the actors were actually crying, which began to slowly discord as the crying got harder. SpongeBob opened his eyes and said to his parents and Patrick,
"As you were with me for my life, you will be with me for my death."
Both SpongeBob's parents and Patrick ran away, screaming in terror. After the funeral, it showed SpongeBob's dad in SpongeBob's house, as he was seen, hanging from a noose in the kitchen. SpongeBob's mom is in the bathroom with slit wrists and was lying dead on the floor, and Patrick is outside, cutting open his stomach as he groans in pain. The episode then cut to black, as the file closed itself. Ever since this, my brother has been having nightmares since he watched that so-called episode, and refuses to watch or do anything related to SpongeBob ever again.